color I'm going to use is a fluorescent green, and I'll put the names of all of the brands and the colors that I've used in the bottom bar. Second color is a fluorescent pink or a neon pink. The third color is a vivid sky blue. The fourth color is a neon yellow. And the last color is a purple. I couldn't quite find a neon color to match that purple, but this is the closest that I could get. You can substitute whatever colors you want to use. And then I applied a sparkle coat over the nail polish. I applied approximately 1 to 2 coats the sparkle polish over it and waited for everything to dry before starting to do the designs. Using a black striper polish, what I did here was use something with a zebra print just for reference so that I could see the way that the pattern flowed. So you want to start with very slow strokes on either end of the nail. Now I did some that were Y-shaped and some that were single lines. I did some smaller lines that sort of fit in between the fork of the Y shapes. One thing in particular with this design is you do not want to make straight lines. It makes it look fake and it does not have a realism about it. If you look at a natural zebra print, the lines are very shaky, very organic, so that's what you want to do. In fact, if you have shaky hands, it might actually be, you know, a good thing for this tutorial. So you want to keep them very free flowing from either side. You can have some that are curving around each other, always from left to right. Do some lines that are thicker and some lines that are thinner. Some lines have little forks and some lines are just wavy. The main thing about all of these lines that you need to remember is that the base of them, or when you start out with them, they should be thicker, and by the time you end with the line, it should be very thin at the end, almost wispy. So what I do is I allow the brush just to trail very lightly as I come to the end, and that gives me the perfect flick or finishing to the line. You want to be very organic. Don't overthink it too much. It tends to come out much more better, much more realistic if you just let it flow. You don't want to have big gaps in designs. At the same time, you don't want to overpower the nail with too many at the same time. The eye does not get the opportunity to focus on the pattern if it's too busy. The very last step, once all the lines are done, you want to wait for them to completely dry and then put your favorite top coat over it. And this is the finished product.